Oh. We are gathered here to join in holy matrimony Carla Lois Maria Brown and Eric Redrick Baum. Marriage is a solemn obligation. It means giving up certain rights and liberties in exchange for new joys and happiness. And by appearing for this ceremony, you indicate that you wish to enter into this relationship. Marriage is an outward expression of private as well as personal feelings, and we're especially pleased to share this moment. Carla and Eric, your appearance here is an acknowledgement of your friendship, love, and trust for each other. Your exchange of marriage vows is an expression of your desire to continue this commitment of friendship, love, and trust. Eric, do you take Carla, whom you hold by the right hand, to be your lawful wedded wife? And do you promise to be a loving and faithful and devoted husband, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep you only unto her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Carla, do you take Eric, whom you hold by the right hand, to be your lawful wedded husband? And do you promise to be a loving and faithful and devoted wife, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep you only unto him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
May we have the ring? The ring is an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual bond uniting two loyal hearts in one. Eric, would you please place the ring on Carla's finger and repeat after me? This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
Carla, would you please place the ring on Eric's finger and repeat after me? This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
Okay. This time y'all have personal vows you wanted to say.
Eric, there's so many things that I want to tell you. I couldn't think of what I wanted to say, but three words. I love you. So much. You are the epitome, the definition of love, and I promise to strive every day to fulfill that definition, my words. I love you. Love is everything. Love is all things, and love is all we need.
I tried to sit down and write some vows for you, and I came up with this. It's a little unconventional. But as I sat there beside my bedside table, I was faced with an impossible task. I was to somehow funnel every single emotion I had into a few quick phrases over a period of a couple of seconds. Well, Carla, I found that was impossible. In a few quick phrases, I couldn't begin to explain the depth of my feelings for you. In a couple of colorful adjectives, I couldn't even try to explain the warmth that wells up in with me every time I gaze into your eyes. I wouldn't dare try to describe the shower of cold that rains in the pit of my stomach when after anticipation of waiting just to see you for the first of the day. A Hallmark cliche couldn't tell about the simple warmth of your touch places. I can't even read this. How with every embrace, I feel a sense of security as if you rescued me from some burning building. How with that very embrace, I wish I can pull you inside of me so you can experience that feeling with me. How I with every kiss feel electricity that forces my eyes open, but then lulls them back to sleep like a baby in his mother's arms. Dear, I wish four letters could encompass what smolders deep whenever I hear your name, when I think of us together, when I long for your company. Something describe what I saw in you at a first glance. What made my pursuit of you relentless and what drove me to stand here before you today and ask you to be with me forever. Carla, I honestly am at a loss of words. So I'm going to say this as simply as possible. And I'm sure it's been said better, more colorful, more brightly. But here it goes. I love you.
For as much as Carla and Eric have consented together in wedlock and have witnessed the same before this company, and thereto have pledged their faith each to the other, and have declared the same by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings, by the power vested in me by the state of Georgia and the constitution thereof, I pronounce you husband and wife. Eric, you may kiss the bride.
time we're going to introduce the wedding party. The best man, we have Keith Raymond Bayman. And the maid of honor, Trina Janine Brown.
I'm sorry, it's going to take a minute. Can you play for one more second?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Friends and family, this beautiful day could never be complete without asking the blessing of our Almighty God upon this arrangement. So this moment, we'd like to take time out to give thanks for this meal that has been prepared for us. And we hope that we'll all be able to partake of it. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to ask God's blessing upon this arrangement and upon this meal. Our kind, loving Father in the heavens, we give you thanks for this beautiful day of life that we're enjoying. We thank you, dear Father, for this young bride and bridegroom. We thank you for all the friends and family who came out to pay respects to this wonderful arrangement. Most of all, dear Father, we thank you for such an arrangement. We thank you also for this meal that you've provided for us. May we all partake of it and be nourished by it. We ask that you watch over us, guide and protect us, and help us to enjoy ourselves. We ask all this in the name of your dear Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So our tables are combined, and we know that we can stand in line, okay? We're going to buffet style.
A brief toast. First of all, to the newlyweds, Eric, Carla, congratulations. Eric, you've been my best friend since we were boys, coming up in junior high. We've taken a lot of steps together. You've taken that final sacred step, and I'm proud of you. Okay? So this is to the bride and groom.
Here.
And I also would like to perform a toast. To my brother and Carla Bayham. I'm very proud to see that you're really taking this big step. And only thing that I ask is that it's not how fast or slow you travel down the road of life, but as long as you take every step together. And that's all that counts. To that.
Thank you.
drop it. Pressure, pressure.
Thank you.
One, two, three.
There you go. I heard threatening.
Okay, your turn.
Do it.
There we go.
Do it.
One, two, three. That's a big thing. He's tempted. I can see he's tempted.
That's it.
Does that taste good?
So now there a cake cutter, like a cutter.
Thank you.
Okay, as they pick up what's left of the flowers, we're going to set up shop for the room.
Hopefully.
After we've gotten married, and this is it.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for a beautiful wedding.
Thank you, the entire Brown Sinclair, Faham Anderson family.
Thanks, friends and family, for coming to our wedding. It was beautiful.
Nice thing.
We had a lot of fun, lots more fun to be had today.
Yeah, and it makes it almost worth all the headache and trauma and, and everything else. The wedding was beautiful. It celebrates the union.
No one else will speak. Everyone's chicken. This one is for Eric. You know what I'm saying? This is he's a former choir member at CAU, and this is one of his favorite tunes. In fact, if he were up here, he'd be trying to direct right now.
That's a hint, Eric.
Have a seat, y'all. Have a seat.
Conventional stuff, but baby.
I do. And I just want to tell you that I want to with you. Yeah, baby, if you do too.
Love you. touch your lips and then remain cool, sustain. To let my words caress your ear and say the things you long to hear. But instead I blow a kiss to what might have been. I know I do.